tips on how you can add value to your life on a daily basis. The first is, know your life's purpose. Have a vision for yourself. Through a good vision statement, you'll find it easier to do justice to all the aspects of your life. A vision helps you to push your boundaries and not get into your own comfort zone. It compels you to do things that you would have not done otherwise. It helps you to build a life by design and not by chance. The next would be a mission statement. A mission statement is how you plan to achieve your vision, the road to achieve that vision, how you want to do things to achieve your goal on a daily basis, to reach there in the future. It directs and keeps you on the right track. It's like a roadmap to reach there. So what you need to do here is write down your vision and your mission statement. Visualize. Learn to prioritize your things on a daily basis, all your activities. Learn to prioritize. Prioritizing would help you to be sorted and not jumbled and crampled up and haphazard in your daily routine. Today you can Google search, my dear friends, and take insight from the personal vision and mission statements of famous CEOs. This will give you a lot of insight and direction and a purpose on how you should go ahead with regard to your vision and mission statement. Next is love yourself, which is so important, my dear friends. For this, you need to spend time with yourselves. Know yourselves like an open book. Discover and explore yourself. One very important here for you in order to love yourself is to put an end to self-harm. Self-harm how? Through the negative self-talk that we do on a daily basis. The self-pity, feeling sad for self, judging yourself, condemning yourself, putting yourself down continuously, comparing yourself with others and giving in to guilt. In order for you to grow in this area, you need to do a SWOT analysis to realize all the strengths that you have within you. They are your weapons. Your strength is your weapon. Build on that. If you're average there, build up in that area and become excellent. Where you're weak, work on it on a daily basis, consistently. Take on opportunities, get stronger in the things that you want to improve upon. Practice on a daily basis. Prepare and perform. The next is growing in your skills. We all have this neurological wirings within us, friends. There's nothing that you and me or anyone in this world cannot learn or pick up. Pick up something new, my dear friends, that you're scared about. For example, so many students come to us in college and say, "Ma'am, we want to improve our English. We want to improve our communication skills." So what you need to do is listen to more of videos, read a lot. When you do these things on a consistently basis and you create an environment for yourself to speak. So listening, reading and speaking, when you consistently do it on a daily basis, the neurons within you would get strength, will become stronger. The same would go for any other skill or any other thing you want to pick up or any subject you want to pick up that you think you have less knowledge over there. Dig into that subject deeper and deeper. Go to your teachers, meet people who have a lot of knowledge in that. And when that interest ignites within you, right, slowly what will happen, the neurological wirings within you will become stronger and then you will become things easier. You'll become strong in that area. Suddenly you'll realize, okay, with my communication, I've grown in more confidence. Fear's gone into the bin now. And there's a lot of confidence. I can face a crowd. I can look eye to eye into a crowd and stand and speak. The next thing, my dear friends, is have an inquisitive mind. The things that you want to learn, that you want to grow in, example, your domain knowledge, be a step ahead than others, than your teacher. See which multi-disciplines it interconnects with, it intersects with, and try to get a lot of knowledge in that area. The next step which I can vouch for is to be an early riser. Being an early riser makes you alert. You become one with nature. You have time to plan out your day, be ahead. Everything just simply falls into place. You become more focused, disciplined, and you invest time more wisely. The next is surrounding yourself with good things and people. It's good if we try to invest our time very productively with people and who are very productive in nature, who spend their day and time very wisely. If we spend our time in unproductive activities, it steals away our time. It makes us feel guilty. So make friends with people who are passionate about their growth. Allow positive energy to build up in you, and automatically you will be surrounded, my dear friends, with positive people, positive situations, positive opportunities. Wonderful things will happen in your life and things will just fall in place. But allow the energy to be positive in you. Next, very important, is to have a mentor. It's very important, my friends, to listen to criticism. And for this, you need to have someone who knows you well, who cares for you, who's willing to see you grow, and who's willing to journey along with you. Ask for guidance, for genuine feedback, and start putting that into practice. The next is pray, meditate, exercise, and do a lot of mindful breathing. Prayer helps you to be one with God. You communicate with God as a friend, not as a God, He's there and you are here. No, as a friend, just as you share with your best friend secrets on a daily basis, you need to see God in a new light now, as a friend. Unburden yourself. Tell Him how you feel, how you think, how you really are as a person from within. Be yourself before your Creator. Be filled with His presence, which is so full of love, peace, joy, faith, and a lot more. Once you encounter God and you experience His presence on a daily basis, things would become much more peaceful for you. You can combine prayer and meditation together. You'll be a more calm and a composed person. Exercise helps you to release all the toxins from your system. It rejuvenates you. And when you deep breathe, it has an alkaline effect and immediately alters our mood. There's a burst of energy, of oxygen in the brain. So mindful breathing reduces stress, anxiety, negative emotions. It enables you to cool down when your temper flares up, and it sharpens your concentration skills. Happy and contented thoughts, my dear friends, release happy hormones such as serotonin and endorphins. They flow throughout your body, benefiting all the muscles and organs of your body. These hormones send a message of well-being to your brain, which in turn affects your body. We know in psychology, the mind and body is connected. As you think, so you feel. As you feel, so you act. So in today's demanding work environments, mindful breathing, it's a deep breathing. It is a tool we should all know how to use very tactfully, very skillfully. You practice it 15 minutes a day and you'll see a remarkable difference in your life. I'll just give you a small demo of this. You breathe in at the count of 5. You hold till the count of 7. Hold your breath till the count of 7. And you release your breath through your nostrils at the count of 5. So breathe in 5 seconds. Hold your breath for 7 seconds. And release your breath for 7 seconds. Don't open your mouth during this entire time. I'll give you a demo of this. I can already feel a lot of peace within me. I vouch that if you practice this on a daily basis, mindful breathing, it will soothe in your mind, it will soothe in your nerves, in your body, and you'll be so much calm and composed. The next is grow in your emotional intelligence and social intelligence. The value of emotional intelligence as of today is immense. Gone are the days when employers wanted employees who are only good in their IQ, who are sound in their IQ. But today's employers want their candidates to have a sound emotional stability, someone who is able to work well in teams, and someone who in turn is socially intelligent. The value of EI is immense. The first step here is self-awareness. The first step is to remove, it's very essential to remove the mask we wear. Be aware of the world within you. Accept yourself just the way you are. Recognize your emotions, how they affect your thoughts, how they affect your behavior, and how they affect your relationships with others. Here comes an important line here. Do I act or do I react? If I react, then I need to manage myself in conflicting situations. Because when I manage myself in conflicting situations, I'll be able to have emotional stability within me as I get more stronger in self-awareness and self-management. Once you've grown in self-awareness and self-management, you become socially aware. You become more patient and understanding with yourself, and in turn what you do, you automatically start having empathy towards others. You grow in your understanding of others' emotions, their needs, the concerns of people, and you make people feel very comfortable with you. The next, how it leads to relationship management. Slowly and steadily, my dear friends, you'll be mastering the art of developing and maintaining good relationships. You'll be communicating clearly. You'll be inspiring and influencing others. You'll know how to contribute well in a team, to give the whole self of you. Selfishness will just move out from within you, and you'll learn to be more selfless, manage conflicts very well, and that in turn, my dear friends, your emotional stability would lead to social intelligence. So, emotional intelligence leads to social intelligence. I hope, my dear friends, you're picking up and you're learning good things from this session. What would be your takeaways from this session on outpouring your best version to society? It's very essential that you know that your life is a gift from God. You are created, you and me. Each person in this world is created with purpose and for a purpose. Find out what that purpose is. For that, you must love yourself, crave for your growth, develop yourself consistently on a daily basis in every area of your life. Don't neglect your inner self. Persevere in this. Pray. Have passion. Have patience with yourself. Be hopeful that you're going to see a new version of you each year. There'll never ever, my dear friends, once again I repeat, be another you in this entire universe ever again. You've got this one opportunity of life, and we have to make the best use of it. Master your emotional intelligence, my dear friends. You want to succeed in life? Academics, growing in your IQ, it's good. Mastering your studies, your subjects, it's good. But then know to be a well-balanced person in society. I not only need to have a good IQ and knowledge, but I need to master myself, my emotions. I need to be emotionally stable. And this in turn would lead to social intelligence. This will undoubtedly, my dear friends, lead you on the path of success. There'll be no stopping for you. You'll be a very charged person from within, and I guarantee you that. You'll be a very charged person within yourself, and you'll know there'll be no stopping. You'll want to outpour the best version of yourself on a daily basis. You won't be another Malala. You won't be another Gates. You won't be another Abdul Kalam sir. You'll be another you. Your own unique you, your own unique identity. You'll be adding richness not only to your life, my dear friends, but to everyone who surrounds you in your family, at your college, at your future workplace. When you go to any functions or any gatherings, you'll bring life to that particular place. So you'll be a blessing to society. Dear participants, my dear friends, I call you friends because we all are joined together by the bond of humanity, right? So it's a call. Life is a call for you and for me, not just to survive, but to thrive. Let me speak in the words of Les Brown, and which I often quote to my students at college. It is better to be prepared and not have an opportunity. Be prepared today, though not many opportunities may come your way. Okay? Rather than having opportunities in future and not being prepared. That's the worst harm we would be doing to ourselves by having opportunities and not being prepared. So no matter what your situation, what has happened in the past, what environments we have come from, that shouldn't be a stopping for you. Bring your thoughts this day, my dear friends, to this moment and all the good you can do for yourself today from this moment on for your growth. The days you spend as a student are your days of preparation. Because you are living to face life, you are preparing to face life, to handle life, all the opportunities, the challenges that would come your way. So dear friends, as we come to the end of this session, are you ready to take up this challenge? The challenge of saying yes to life, yes to your growth, yes to outpouring the best version of yourself, your version to the world. Are you ready to be a blessing to the world? The time is now. The time is now. The moment is now. Say yes, crave for your growth, and give your best version to society. So this is Sonia Francis, ma'am, and I thank you for listening very patiently. Put all these factors, these elements, these features into practice on a daily basis, and you'll see a new you, an improvised version of you, gifted to the world, to society. God bless you all and all the very best.